video is going to be about determining whether a relationship is a function. So let's take a simple example and understand what that means. Let's say I've got an equation like y equals x plus 2. And we're going to say that x is the input, it's the independent variable, and y is the output or the dependent variable. So a function is a rule such that whatever input I give it, it will always give me for that input a specific output. In other words, let's say I decide that x is 3. My input is 3. This rule, y equals x plus 2, will always give me an output, a y, a dependent variable, of 5. If I say that x is negative 2, the output will always be 0. I can change the input, but each time I change the input, I'm going to get a predictable output. I'm never going to have something where I put in, let's say, a 5 as my input, and sometimes it tells me 7, and sometimes it tells me 12. As long as I give it the same input, it will always give me the same predictable output. Now, I can express a function, a mathematical function, as an equation, but there are other ways to express them as well. I could express it as a graph, or I could express it as a table. So let's look at some other ways. Here are some tables. In this first table, I've got my input is the x column, that's the independent variable. The output is going to be the y column, the dependent variable. So for my independent variable, I've got a negative 1, and my output is 3. When my input is 0, my output is 5. When my input is 1, my output is 7. When my input is 2, my output is 9. So as long as I know what the input is, I will always know exactly, without a doubt, what the output is. But let's look at a different table. Let's look at this next one. Here, I've got input is negative 1, output is 3. Input is 0, output is 5. Input is negative 1, and output is 7. And then input is 2, and output is 9. But look at the ones where I've got an input of negative 1. Sometimes it tells me the output is 3. Sometimes it tells me the output is 7. So this table does not represent a function. Here's a third table. Here I've got an input that's negative 1 and an output that's 5, an input that's 0 and an output that's 6, input is 1, output is 7, input is 2, output is 6. Now, in two cases, I had the same output. When my input was 0, my output was 6. When my input was 2, the output was 6. This is still a function, because as long as I know the input, I will know specifically what the output is. Compare that to the function in the middle here, where when the input was negative 1, I'm not sure what the output is. It could be 3, it could be 7. So basically, if you're looking at a table, as long as none of the numbers are repeated in the input column, we're going to have a function. It doesn't matter if we repeat numbers like the 6 and the 6 in the third table. It doesn't matter if we repeat numbers in the output column. It's only the input column that I'm going to be concerned with. That's why the function in the middle is, why the table in the middle is not a function, because I've repeated an input, negative 1, and I've got two different outputs for it. Sometimes it's 3, sometimes it's 7. Now, something to remember is I can also express the information in a table as a set of ordered pairs. So here I've got a set where I've got 3, 5, 4, 7, 5, 9, 6, 11. And the inputs are the first number in each ordered pair. The outputs are the second numbers. As long as I'm not repeating any of the first numbers, which I don't in this example, it's going to be a function. The second set of numbers I have, I've got 3, 5, 4, 8, and then 3, 7. So I've repeated a 3 as my input. In one case, my output, the second number, is a 5. In the other case, my output is a 7. So this set of numbers, the second set of numbers, is not a function. In the third set that I've got 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6, 6. The output can stay the same. The output seems like it's always going to be 6, but I'm not repeating any of the inputs. I've only got 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, and 1, 6. So I know specifically, without a doubt, what output I get for each of those numbers. Okay? Now, let's look at some tables. Let's look at some graphs and see if we can understand whether they're functions or not. So let's say I've got a graph and I draw a line like this. What we're going to do is use what's called the vertical line test. The vertical line test says this. If I can take a vertical line and like this stick here and move it across my graph, and it never touches more than one part of the graph, then I've got a function. Let's look at an example that's not a function to compare that. Okay, so here I'm going to draw something like a circle. If I put my vertical line so it touches the circle, you see it touches it in two places. Now, let's say that this point here on my x-axis was 1, that would mean that when my input is 1 from my x-axis, my output might be this point. This might be 1, 1, or it might be this point. This might be 1, 3. So this has failed the vertical line test, and it's not a function. Here are some other examples of graphs that are functions and graphs that are not functions. So this graph is a function. The graph doesn't have to be continuous, as the main thing is I can't run a vertical line across it and have it touch the graph in more than one place at any point. A graph like this is a function. Once again, it passes the vertical line test. Here are some graphs that aren't functions. In this S-shaped graph, if I run a vertical line down the middle of the S part of it, it touches the graph in three places. So once again, if my input is, let's say, 1, I don't know if my output is down here, or over here, or over here. So that's not going to be a function. One more. If I have a graph, and I've got a vertical line, a line straight up and down, that is absolutely not a function because it fails the vertical line test everywhere. Okay, so that's not a function. Let's look at a few equations quickly and see if they're functions or not. Here I've got y equals negative 2x plus 4. Well, that's a function because whatever I put in as x, I'm going to get a specific answer out as y. Whatever I put in as x, I will always get the same answer out as y. Here I've got 2x plus y equals 4. If I want to consider x the independent variable and y the dependent variable, this is a function because basically this function, this equation is the same as the first one. I just rearranged it. Let's look at y equals x squared minus 4x plus 3. Well, that's a function. If you tell me what you want x to be, let's say you tell me x is going to be 3, I can calculate what x squared is, subtract 4x from it, add 3, and that will tell me what y is. I'll always get the same answer. But what about this? Y equals plus or minus the square root of x plus 2. That's not going to be a function, because once I figure out what the square root of x plus 2 is, depending on the x that you give me, I'm going to say it's either plus that amount or minus that amount. Well, if I say it's either one thing or another, it's not a function. I've always got to come up with the same answer. A simple example of this non-function would be y equals plus or minus x. If you tell me x is 2, then maybe the output is 2, maybe it's negative 2. It's up to me to decide, but it's not a function. Okay? So basically, that's how you're going to decide whether a relationship that you're given, either as a graph or as a table or as an equation, whether it's a function or not. That's all there is to it. Take care. I'll see you next time.